Hello there. Welcome to another episode of The Bowman Show. We just got done talking about the brain and its functions, and we just had a great interview with Bill Nye, the science guy, going over some of the brain and its functions, the three different parts of the brain, and he did a hell of a job with that. Stay tuned. Today's going to be a great episode with another famous doctor in the medical field. More like everybody's talking about the Bowman Show, and we got a great one here for you today. We are interviewing Doc Brown. You got that right, from the Back to the Future series. Yeah, stay tuned. Great Scott. It's going to be a good one. Hey, Doc, thanks for coming on the show today. I know I'm taking up a little bit of your time with all these crazy experiments with Marty McFly, but I appreciate you coming on the show today.
Great Scott, Mr. Bowman. Thanks for having me on today. I appreciate it. Forward to discussing brain and what else you have in mind.
Awesome. Hey, thanks for letting me use the DeLorean to go back in time to pick up some of these historical figures to keep this show running. I really appreciate it, and I think the students do too.
Absolutely. That's what I made it for, to be able to go back and learn from history and maybe even change it. Obviously make our lives better.
Yeah, sweet. Hey, sorry for the little surprise I left for you in the back seat.
No problem. I had Marty cleaned that up.
good. I'm glad you did. Hey, Doc. So, let's face it. We just got done talking about the brain and its functions. And I just want to talk a little bit today about the hemispheres of the brain. And then I want to get into the corpus callosum and how that's important, how that's significant. And also split brain procedure. So, what do you have to say about the left and right hemisphere of the brain? What kind of functions, tasks do they perform?
Well, obviously, Mr. Bowman, the brain is extremely complex. A lot of neural activity that goes on in the brain. There's something that's thrown around a lot. That's whether someone is right hemisphere oriented or left hemisphere
oriented. Oh, I hear that a lot.
Yeah, you do hear that a lot. And actually, it's a myth. Our brain works together. Now, obviously, our right hemisphere controls the left side of our body in terms of our motor movements, and then the left hemisphere controls our right side of our body in terms of our motor movements.
So they can get into like cross across your body to control
exactly.
your so the right part of your brain controls the left side of your body.
Yeah, so to give you an example, if you're viewing something in the right visual field, in your right visual field, that's going to be processed in the left side of your brain. Vice versa, if you view something in your left visual field, it'll be processed in the right side of your brain.
Really? I never knew
exactly.
That.
Exactly. Yeah, and your brain communicates with one another, so that's kind of a myth that you're either right hemisphere or left hemisphere. But research has shown that the left or the right hemisphere do specialize more in specific functions.
Okay.
So logic is not just confined to the left hemisphere, and there's no evidence that either creativity or intuition has an exclusive property of the right hemisphere. It is impossible to educate one hemisphere at a time, and there's no evidence that people are right-brained or left-brained, like I said before. So what are the differences, you're probably thinking, right?
Yeah, seriously, yeah.
So what the differences are, at least what studies have shown, is that the brain does reveal that the left hemisphere is more active when a person deliberates over decisions. So when they're trying to make a decision, and we make thousands of decisions every single day, correct?
Oh, of course. Some good, some really bad.
Yeah, exactly. I make good decisions. McFly makes good decisions. Now, Biff, on the other hand, he doesn't make good decisions, correct?
Biff is a terrible character.
He is a terrible character. You know, just so much trouble with him. But yeah, the left hemisphere deliberates over decisions that we have during the day. The right hemisphere is more associated with simple requests, so things that are a little bit quicker, you know, perceiving objects, easily perceiving objects, so that quick, intuitive response that is needed, okay? So let's just say something jumps out of nowhere and scares us, right? We need that quick, intuitive response in order to react to it, and that mostly would be associated with the right hemisphere.
Really?
And it's also more, it's also more active when copying drawings, recognizing faces, and also perceiving emotions. So you're looking at someone's face, and they are expressing a specific facial feature, which obviously is an emotion. Our right right part of our hemisphere is processing that perception, that sensory information.
Okay, so you're saying that quick abilities, quick judgments, reactions, and then spatial fixtures. So just focusing on pictures and understanding concepts like that, right?
Exactly.
Okay. So definitely with wrestling, right? That's one thing that, and any other sport, right hemisphere brains are mostly dominant, and you see a lot of activity from that right hemisphere when performing these tasks, right?
I would say that if you're talking specifically athletics, okay. I would say that those individuals may have some more glial cells in their right hemisphere of the brain. So remember, glial cells, I don't know if you covered that in class yet or not.
Not much.
Glial cells provide nutrients to your neurons, okay? And we think of, or we try to understand why some people are more intelligent than others, and we might think, oh, man, Albert Einstein or
Doc Brown.
Bill Gates or Steve Jobs, they must have huge brains because they're so much smarter than us. They're not smarter than us. They just probably have more glial cells, so their neural activity is strengthened by those glial cells because of the nutrients provided for them. So athletes probably have a little bit more glial cells in their right hemisphere, which allows them to be quick and intuitive and respond to certain things, particularly in wrestling, like you said.
I got you. Hey, Doc, don't sell yourself short there. You should be characterized with those scientists there.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Great Scott! Well, anyway, so like Ethan Paul with wrestling and everything, he's a great upper dolphin wrestler. So his right hemisphere is going nuts, going AWOL. His glial cells are going crazy whenever he's right ready to take a shot, right? So he's all over that leg, no problem. Really quick reactions, no problem. He's in there. Take that kid down, right?
Great Scott, woman. Are you all right?
Well, I know. I grabbed the microphone there. I should have done it. I always like grabbing and wrestling with it every now and then. My right hemisphere is going AWOL. I think that's what it is.
It must be.
Awesome. So we hit home pretty much the right hemisphere there. That's great stuff here. So what about the left side, the left hemisphere?
Like I said, that's more associated with deep processing. So we're talking about logical thinking, okay? That's where kind of our creativity comes with. And our left hemisphere is also associated with our language, our ability to be able to speak to the people. So when we're talking about people that are more inclined to stand out and be leaders of a group and take the initiative and speak out, maybe get up in front of people, and they're very comfortable in talking, their Wernicke's area, the Broca's area, which is located in the left side of their brain, the left hemisphere, probably is a little bit more advanced, and they may have some glial cells in that part of their brain that allows them to have those more advanced parts of the brain and then allow them to speak a little bit better in front of people.
I got you. So the left side of the brain's more, you know, interacting with people, properly making right decisions and strategy, planning, things like that.
Language
acquisition. Okay.
Yep.
So you said the Broca's area, Weinrich's area. Dr. Knock, the guy that we had on recently, he talked about that pretty well. I think the students understand that good.
Good.
Yeah.
You know, I heard that guy is a great guy.
I heard so too. He really hits home with some of the finer details that we need to know and understand. And let's face it, he's a pretty good golfer.
I heard that also. I might have to just travel in time to hit around with him.
You're going to have to. Hey, you better be holding his clubs because he'll be scoring all over you, that's for sure. All right, so the right hemisphere, left hemisphere. Right hemisphere, we're dealing with more spatial you know, more understanding of quick trigger motions, movements. Okay, so like, let's say you're an artist, right? Or you can understand picture books. If you want to grab a picture book, you're more right hemisphere. You see things just with a spatial picture orientation. And then the left side of the brain. Yep. So left side of the brain, you're reading, you're writing. You have a better understanding of speech production, speech acquisition, things like that, right?
Yeah, you're more logistical, mathematical in terms of your intelligence.
Okay. So you're saying more high IQ people have a stronger left hemisphere than right, I'm guessing.
Yes, I would say that their left hemisphere is highly functioning.
Okay, so those glial cells are really going at it and functioning with the neurons to fire and understand these different concepts and processes that are given to them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely.
Nice. All right, so right and left hemisphere. I think we talked about that pretty good. So what connects the two? I mean, it's just not floating there, right? There has to be some connection between the right and left hemisphere.
Exactly. And like we said before, it's the brain's not lateralized because it's connected. It communicates with one another. So we're not left brain. We're not right brain.
Okay. That's a myth, right?
Both hemispheres are connected via the corpus callosum, which is kind of like a little neural highway that connects the two brains. So a pair of neurons.
Okay. So the corpus callosum, that's the bridge. That's the shoelaces. That's tying this thing together, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Great Scott.
Is that Marty McFly in the background? In a young age.
I tell you, huh?
Is that Marty McFly in the background in a young age or something?
Yeah, I know. We traveled back in time a little bit too far. And, we got him at a young age there, but that's all right. We'll just get back in that DeLorean and fly back to where we need to be.
All right, no problem.
But anyways, that corpus callosum connects the two, so they're able to communicate with one another. So the brain is kind of working together as one. But one may be thinking, what happens if we would separate that brain?
Oh, yeah, wait a minute. So I loved how you referenced that. The corpus callosum was like a neural highway connecting the two hemispheres together. And what did you say? What would happen if you split it? Why would you do that?
Exactly. Yeah, and there has been experiments done in the past where the brain has been split. So one of the original experiments was done by a man by the name of Dr. Gazinga.
Gazinga!
Gazinga!
It's almost like Bazinga.
Yeah. Gazinga. And what he did was he was trying to find a cure for patients that were suffering from epilepsy, which is severe seizures.
Okay.
And what they did, and what this epilepsy does is the brain is kind of like there's mini electric, I'm trying to make it relevant here for the kids, like mini electrical storms just firing all over the place. So there's too much activity going on in the brain. And when there's too much activity going on in certain parts of the brain at the same time, it results in kind of an overload. It's like a computer being overloaded, and then all of a sudden there's sparks flying everywhere and things aren't operating correctly.
Oh, I've had that done to me before. Not going to tell you why, but yeah, it's happened.
Yeah, exactly. when this happened, you know, they're trying to, these doctors are trying to figure out, you know, how do we lessen these seizures and improve the lives of these patients. So what they did was they severed this corpus callosum, which connects the right and left hemisphere of the brain. And actually, it was very successful in resolving that issue of epilepsy.
Really?
The patients experienced less seizures.
Wow, that's some interesting stuff. I can only imagine. You know, the communication, the conversation between the doctors there that were trying to go over this, like, I think I have a great idea. Let's just cut this right in half. Like, what do you mean? I can't believe that's a decision that someone would make. But, hey, you said it worked, right?
Exactly. It worked, at least for that issue. You know, and I know, because I'm good friends with Dr. Knock myself.
Yeah.
And you guys talked about how messing with the brain and probing the brain and sending electrodes into the brain can stimulate different things and make life better, you know, BBS. In this case, however, there was some negative side effects.
It had to be.
So by split, it solved the issue of epilepsy in terms of not having as many seizures as they did before, and in some cases the seizures are non-existent anymore. However, by splitting that brain, you don't have that communication between the left and the right anymore, correct?
Yeah, like what are you going to do? You can't figure out pictures, spatial information, and then you have language acquisition, things like that. How does that work? You know, if
exactly.
You split that
so
in half.
They did an experiment with these patients, and I'll give you an example here.
Yeah.
So they would present a word in the right visual field of one of the patients, correct?
Okay.
And it could be whatever word you want, okay? And then what they did was they asked those patients to verbalize that word. Well, we know that anything in the right visual field, from what we talked about earlier, is processed in what part of the brain?
Yeah. Okay.
What part of the brain is it processed in?
What,
the left hemisphere, right?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. We have the Broca's area, the Weinrich's area is over there, right?
Yeah, which is dealing with language, correct? So
yeah.
They weren't able to verbalize that because the right visual field wasn't connected with the left hemisphere of the brain anymore because the corpus callosum was there. But they could draw it. So let's just say, give me a random word. I don't even know. Give me something to draw.
Let me see here. How about Yoda? Yoda, Star Wars. May the 4th happened just the other day, so why not? Yoda's pretty cool, right?
May the 4th be with you.
Oh, exactly.
Exactly. So you got Yoda being presented in your right visual field.
Love
you're
Yoda.
You're asked to say Yoda.
Yeah.
Or say what it is. You can't, but you can draw it, okay? And why can you draw it? Because drawing is associated with right hemisphere functioning, okay? Motor coordination, motor movement, right?
Yeah.
So therefore, the right hemisphere moves your left hand and you're able to draw that Yoda, even though you can't say it because that's associated with your left hemisphere.
I gotcha. So they couldn't really pronounce, they couldn't say it, who it was, but they could draw it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotcha. Oh, wow. I tell you what, Doc Brown, he brings the information and the magic with him everywhere he goes. For some reason, he just disappeared into the future or the past. Who knows? But anyway, that was a great interview with him. He talked about the right and left hemisphere, what functions they have, and the corpus callosum, which connects the right and left hemisphere. And also, he talked about split brain procedure. What happens if seizures, epilepsy occurs? You know, some people thought the best way to maneuver around that is to just cut it right in half. So, there you have it, guys. What a great interview. Hope you learned something today. So, here's some Billy Joel to finish off the lesson.
Next